大 vs 小，作者黄江河。什么是最大？什么是最小？一只已经成为二栖明星的青蛙并不满足，他想，我能在水中游，陆上跳，如果再能在天上飞，就成为一只三栖明星的青蛙了。到那时，我就成了所有青蛙崇拜的偶像。于是，这只青蛙制定了一份详细的飞行计划。照着计划，青蛙每天苦练飞翔的本领。可无论它怎么练习，却没有什么效果。青蛙并没有因此而放弃，心想，是不是自己的练习方法不对？他细心地观察着鸟类的飞翔，发现雄鹰都在高高的悬崖上起飞，小鸟都在高高的枝头上起飞。青蛙明白了，自己之所以飞不起来，是没有找到一个起飞的平台。于是，青蛙沿着一棵树的树干爬上了高高的枝头。青蛙雄心壮志地仰望着蓝天，向上奋力一跃。就在它以为自己飞起来的时候，突然身体不听使唤地向下坠落，最后重重地摔死在地上。面对这只摔死的青蛙，青蛙们想不明白，不是说成功离不开梦想，离不开计划，离不开苦练，离不开坚持，离不开方法吗？这一切在这只摔死的青蛙身上都具备。具备了如此成功条件的青蛙，最后为什么会活活的摔死呢？自己没有翅膀，却偏偏要去练习飞翔，怎么会不摔死呢？老青蛙的一句话，使众青蛙恍然大悟。写到这里，想想我们人类，跟这只青蛙也相差不多。我们不也在这世界上寻寻觅觅那不属于我们的东西吗？圣经上说，不要为自己积攒财宝在地上，地上有虫子咬，能朽坏，也有贼挖窟窿来偷。只要积攒财宝在天上，天上没有虫子咬，不能朽坏，也没有贼挖窟窿来偷。因为你的财宝在哪里，你的心也在哪里。马太福音6:19-21。上帝非常幽默，不是吗？其实他老早就把这些告诉我们了。上帝用数学来训诫我们，他用一个数字把最小和最大的表达出来。零是最小的，可是零也是最大的。你说零是最小的，但是零怎会是最大的？你不同意，好吧，让我慢慢道来。假设你有100美元，加一个零，1000是吧？再加一个零，等于10000；再加一个零，等于100000；再加一个零，等于100万，对吧？再加，再加，再加，再加，等于不得了，千万万富翁。可是 上帝很幽默，他训诫我们，最后到头来也是零，我们什么也不能带走，尘土终归尘土。人追逐的竟然是什么也没有，可是君不见那些富有的每天不是在夸耀他们的财富吗？人啊，你竟然不知你是多么的可怜。主耶稣说，骆驼穿过针的眼，比财主进神的国还容易呢。求主怜悯，打开我们心灵的眼睛，叫我们看见神的荣耀。阿们。 Large versus small. What is the largest? What is the smallest? There was a frog who had been able to enjoy double life, was not content. It thought, I can swim in water, jump on land, and if only if I could fly in the sky, I would enjoy triple life. By then, I would become an idol worshipped by all frogs. So the frog made a detailed flight training plan. Following the plan, the frog practiced flying every day, no matter how hard it tried, but to no avail. That frog didn't give up. It kept asking itself, is this method wrong? It carefully observed the flight of the birds and found that the eagles were all taking off on the high cliffs and the little birds were taking off on the high branches. The frog understood that the reason why he couldn't fly was because he didn't find a platform to take off from. So the frog climbed up to the highest branch along the trunk of a tree. Looking up at the blue sky ambitiously, the frog leaped upward. Just when it thought it was flying, suddenly its body fell uncontrollably and finally dropped to the ground. Facing the death of that frog, the other frogs couldn't understand. Doesn't success come with dreams, plans, hard training, persistence, and methods?That frog had all these. With such conditions for success, why did that frog still drop dead in the end? He had no wings, but wanted to practice flying. How could he not fall to death? The words of the old frog enlightened those confused ones. Now, come to think about it.Aren't we human beings just like this frog? Aren't we also looking for things in this world that do not belong to us? Do not store up for yourselves treasures on earth, where moths and vermin destroy, and where thieves break in and steal. But store up for yourselves treasures in heaven,where moths and vermin do not destroy, and where thieves do not break in and steal. For where your treasure is, there your heart will be also. Matthew 6:19-21. God is very humorous, isn't he? He showed this to us long, long time ago. God used mathematics to teach us.He used a number to express the smallest and largest. Zero is the smallest, but it's also the largest. You would argue, how can it be the largest? Well, let me explain. Suppose You have $100 at 10 equal to 1,000, right? One more zero, 10,000. At one more zero, 100,000. One more zero equal to 1,000,000, right? Add more and more zeros equal to incredible zillionaire. But God is very humorous. He admonishes us that in the end, it is zero. We cannot take anything away from dust to dust. People are chasing nothing, but don't you see that those rich people boast of their wealth all the time? Man, you don't even know how pitiful you are. The Lord Jesus said, "It is easier for a camel to go through the eye of a needle than for a rich man to enter the kingdom of God." May the Lord have mercy on us and open our eyes and let us see the glory of God. Amen.